Good morning, lovely yogis. Today for your practice, you'll need a bolster or pillow, a blanket, as well as a block or thick book. So setting yourself up on your mat with your blanket spread out, your block, sitting onto your block with your knees in a downward slope. Sit up nice and tall through the spine and take a few deep breaths just to center yourself. Telling yourself you're about to practice yoga. Leave the outside world outside. Let your worries fade away. And just being here in this space, showing up for yourself, being present. Starting to focus on your breathing. In and out through the nose. Just your regular breathing rhythm to begin with. Stillness wash over you. And continuing to breathe just like that. You're on week 4 of Asteya, non-stealing. Journal and meditate this week. Think about your dreams and goals. And make a list of things to do, study, or try that will increase your knowledge and competency and bring you closer to your goals, thus building your adikara. Adikara means the authority or ownership of a body of knowledge. It is the right to know. Adikara, this word challenges us the reality that if we want something, then we better grow the competency required to have it. We can dream and wish all we want, but we only get what we have the competency to have and to keep. Anything else is stealing. Our outcomes in life are consistent with our abilities, not necessarily our wishes or our goals. Competency includes the ability to see what is right before us. Building our competency takes practice and learning. Preparing ourselves to hold what we want is an exciting full-time job, and it moves us away from any victim stories into full responsibility for our lives. Non-stealing demands that we become capable of stewarding what we ask for, have the adikara for what we want, and if we are not prepared to contain our deep desires, we can easily find ourselves stealing in all kinds of inappropriate and destructive ways. This jewel asks us instead to focus our desires and then build the competency to have them. It leaves us with the question, are you available to what you want? Life gives us tasks that, should we succeed, grow us into the kind of people that life can trust with important things. Where stealing unleashes pain and suffering on others and ourselves, building our competency opens up a world of joy and possibility. Letting those words sink in and taking 5 more full breaths, starting to activate that ocean breathing. In and out through the nose, slight constriction in the back of the throat, and so that you can hear it out loud in your ears.
Thank you.
your fifth breath, tuck your chin in towards your heart, slowly opening your eyes, and bringing yourself forward off of your block. Feet come into a butterfly position. Just a relaxed butterfly position. Legs can be farther away from you if that feels more relaxing. Remember, this is your practice and your body and your choice. So take a moment, pressing your heels in towards one another. Take a few deep breaths. Letting your body settle in, starting to relax. Feels good for you to bring your hands forward in this pose and yin. You're allowed to round through the spine, giving yourself that full permission to come forward in your own time, in your own way. Heavy, releasing the jaw, letting the tongue rest at the bottom of the mouth. Take five more breaths. Planting your hands down, moving very slowly, roll yourself back up through the spine, all the way lifting your heart, growing the spine. Take a few breaths. Hands come to your knees, and as you lean back, drawing the legs towards one another. Letting yourself rest back on your hands, in your own time, starting to move for your release. Remember, the release is personal for everybody. You have lots of time to slowly release, to slowly move and enjoy that movement. When you're ready, bringing yourself forward into a wide V. Make sure that your torso wants to be up nice and tall. For this one, with your bolster in front of you. You want to hug your bolster into your belly, letting your toes release that flex or hold that they're holding. And then start to breathe as you slowly come forward. You can rest the side of your temple on your bolster. Coming into that peaceful inner world. Focusing on nothing but softening in your breath. Why do we want to do yin yoga? Physically, there are three things that we do to our tissues when we stress them in yoga. Compress, stretching, and twisting. The result of these three stresses are called compression, tension, and shear. In back bends, we compress the facets of the vertebrae into each other. In forward bends, we stretch the fascia and muscles and stress the ligaments along the back of the spine. And in twists, we provide a shearing force between the vertebrae and the ribs, which both compress and stretch tissues between the ribs. So as we're here in this stretch, focus on your body and see if you can tell where you're compressing. Where you are stretching. And there's no shear in this one, but when we do a twist, I'll bring that up again. Let's take five more breaths. Your last breath, slowly start to straighten back up through the spine, removing your bolster to the side. Take a moment just to really lift up through the heart. And then hands to the backs of the knees, and as you lean back, drag the legs to the edges of your mat. Leaning back again, in your own time, windshield wipering. And maybe it feels good to roll onto your back and hug your knees into your belly. Take your time. When you're ready, coming back up. Stretching your legs straight out in front of you. Leaning yourself forward. Wiggling the toes to release the flex. Taking a few deep breaths. And if you'd like to hug your bolster in again, or you can dangle forward here. Whichever you prefer. Long and full. Steady breaths, releasing where you're holding on to tension. So we're stretching all the way from the backs of our heels, backs of the legs, through each vertebrae on the spine and the neck. Take 5 more breaths. Around into tabletop. We're coming into a swan position, so pigeon pose is how it's known in Hatha. If you prefer to do thread the needle on your back, now is the time. So from tabletop, drag your right knee up towards your right wrist, bringing the shin up and stretching the left leg back. Your right foot is holding a flex. Make sure that it is flexed, that protects the knee. Planting your hands in, adjusting yourself. If your right hip is falling towards the ground, put a block underneath it. We do not want it to sink. Take a few deep breaths. And when you're ready, coming down to your elbows. You can use a bolster under your head or under your elbows if that feels good. Letting yourself settle into your own depth. Tracking and seeing where you are stretching, compressing. These movements are rejuvenating and help release stuck toxins and waste within. Even old scar tissue can be broken down in a moment. Watching where your mind is going, staying gentle. See if you can relax through the shoulder blades and the jaw just a little bit more. 5 more breaths. After your last breath, lift your gaze, slowly making your way up to your hands, removing the block, and lifting and letting the right hip sink down. We're going to bring that left leg all the way around so that your right foot crosses under and your left comes over. Into a shoelace pose. So from here, your knees are stacking or look similar. Cross-leg position is a modification here. So hands come down behind. Take a deep breath in, lift up through the heart. And as you exhale, lean yourself forward over your leg, pressing so you feel your leg pressing into your tummy and breathing into that resistance. Puff your cheeks out with your breath. Open and close the jaw a couple times. And then come back down. And let's take 5 more breaths. Very slow and steady. After your last exhale, you're slowly rolling back up through the spine, hitting the pause button once you are vertical. Helping your left leg off of the right, leaning back on the hands. And then hitting that pause button just to feel, or if it's good, windshield wiper, being very aware of your right knee and your left knee too. Good. coming back around, back into your tabletop. You're resetting yourself. Maybe it feels good before you go in to stretch your legs straight back behind you. Your tabletop, you're dragging your left knee towards your left wrist, laying the shin down in front of you, flexing the foot, and being in control of how deep you want to go by stretching your right leg behind you. Remember, if your left hip is trying to sink down, put a block underneath it. Take a moment to adjust, plant your hands in, and take those few deep breaths. Taking a nice deep breath, see if you can relax through the shoulder blades and jaw just a little bit more, watching where your thoughts are going. Bringing them back to the body and to the breath. Let's take five more full breaths. Long and steady. Your last exhale, first lift the gaze. Second, slowly pushing yourself back up, removing your block. And lifting the hips, settling your left hip down. Bringing the right leg up and around. you need to take a pause between to release, you can. Otherwise, your left leg is already tucked under the right. Right comes up and over. Remember that the modification is just a regular cross-leg position, maybe crisscrossing opposite. Hands come behind. Take a few breaths, lifting up the heart. You're ready. Exhale, sink forward. The jaw. Take a moment to puff your cheeks out while you're here. Breathing into that resistance that you might feel with your belly pressed up against the leg. Going through your body and seeing where you're compressing and where you are stretching. Five more breaths. After your last breath, lift your gaze first, straightening out your spine, back nice and tall. Pause. And helping your leg off the other, leaning back on the hands to do a gentle windshield wiper. From side to side, tuning inwards, what's going on, how does the body feel? How do you feel? Similar next pose, bringing the bolster halfway down our mat. Horizontal. We're coming into banana asana. So have your right hip alongside your bolster and lay yourself down so that your waist is draped over the side of the bolster. Now you can have your legs straight down below you with your arms straight up above you, or you can bend your knees. You can bend your arms, you can bend both. Take a moment to see what works for you today. And once you're down, take a few breaths, letting your hip, your waist Take the shape of the bolster melting down towards the earth. What kind of stories you're telling yourself, where the inner landscape takes you. And trying to keep yourself detached from those things. Bringing yourself back to the present moment and to your breathing. And that helps with stillness within. Taking five more full breaths, very slow, very calm. Your last exhale, bend your knees and bend your arms into your fetal position, cradling your head just for a moment. When you're ready, plant your left hand down into the ground. Pause, feeling that connection to the earth. When you're ready, pushing through your palm, bringing yourself up. Switching so that your left hip is alongside the bolster. Laying your waist down over the side. Choosing if you're stretching out or hugging in this time. It doesn't have to look the same. Take a few moments to balance yourself to find the perfect Goldilocks position for you. And then start to breathe and relax. Breathing to relax. Let's take 5 more full breaths. When you're ready, bending your knees up, bending your arms, cradling your head, right hand down to the ground, to ground into the earth. Take a few breaths. When you're ready, pushing yourself back up. Left toes before Shavasana. Bringing ourselves forward with our bolster behind us, coming into waterfall. So you can use a wall as well if you'd like instead. Leaning yourself back and up so that your hips are on the bolster and it makes it comfortable to hold your legs up in the air for a longer amount of time. Shoulder blades are folded underneath. Legs are outstretched, hands are at your sides or on your belly. And simply breathing and floating here. See if you can soften even more through the collarbone and heart, letting all that blood flow back down your legs and into the heart. Take a few moments to bring some movement in, pointing and flexing the toes. And if it feels okay to bring your legs into a wide V shape, maybe bring one leg closer to you, clasping on behind the leg while one leg pulls away. And switching to the other side. Once more. One more time on the other side, taking a few breaths. Bringing both legs up to the sky for five more breaths. Find that softness in the heart. And then bending your knees towards your belly. Slowly let one foot come down towards the ground. And then the other, hit the pause button. Hips sink back. When you're ready, you're lifting your hips, sliding the bolster out. Lowering the lower back down slow and stretching yourself out, preparing for Shavasana. The shoulder blades are folded underneath. Lift the chin towards the heart and slowly place the neck back down. Lots of length in the back of the neck. Arms are at your sides. Feet and legs are falling away from one another. Let's take those three releasing breaths. In through the nose, out through the mouth. Body is relaxed, sinking into the ground below you. Becoming heavy, letting the mind settle on just your natural breathing rhythm.
stillness.
Stretching out or hugging your knees into your belly, you can do both or neither. When you're ready, rolling onto your left side, cradling your head, continuing to breathe and to ground. Breathing in and out first. Thank you so much for tuning in this week. Namaste.